Hello again, Khonius here. Tonight I'm flying from Las Cruces, New Mexico to Roswell, New Mexico. I'm flying a Cessna 208B Grand Caravan. I haven't established my flight level, but it'll probably be 7,500 feet. Thought I would go through my little pre-flight check on camera. So the first thing that occurs to me is the sun is going down, so I should prepare the illumination in advance. And so those controls are here, and so this one is avionics, which tend to be a little on the bright side. So let's see if I can calm those ones down, and then the standby ones also could use, those are the ones right there in the center. Those could be a little dimmer. Glare shield I'm not sure about. This is pedestal, maybe up one. This bypass things in the way, so let's see. This is cabin left side, one up on that, one up on the right. Okay. So that should be good enough for lighting. Alright, the next thing is set a default heading of our current heading. Then, let's see, we're almost 4,500 feet, so let's set a flight level of 7,500 feet. Using the mouse wheel. There's 7,500. Alright. Turn flight director navigation on in advance for autopilot. Alright, I think we are ready to go. Parking brake off. Let's start heading down the runway. Flaps up, start to gain some speed. I'm going to need to make a right turn, get into the proper heading. Steeper.
Albuquerque Center KH-30-3 is type Cessna Caravan 2 miles north of Kilo Lima Romeo Uniform. Request flight following.
KH-30-3 Albuquerque Center.
Okay, so we'll need to continue. Get those lines to line up. Magenta lines.
KH-30-3.
So
KH-30-3 radar contact 2 miles north of Kilo Lima Romeo Uniform, 5,500 feet. Altimeter 0.01.
Try to get lined up right on the
copy KH-30-3.
These lines should begin to converge. Patient when flying. Distances are great. Things happen slowly. But it is starting to converge, so soon I will turn a little to the left and we'll be on course, and I will hand it off to the autopilot. believe we are close enough to engage autopilot. We exceeded our altitude target, so I plan to actually level off. Engage autopilot. Now I did engage nav, so that is on. Flight director is on. I don't see the... Oh, there it is. It's just hard to see because I dimmed the display, the magenta arrows. And it's going to oscillate a little bit until it settles. Alright. I am going to turn on flight level control because I would like to get us back to that altitude. And if I drop throttle, it should be able to do that. If we're gonna have any mountains to go over before we get there. I see something, but I don't think that's going to affect us. Kind of thinking maybe 8,000 would be a better target. We're starting to level off a little bit, give it some more thrust. I think it's still trying to drop, so... Alright, I believe we switched to altitude hold mode, is that right? It's a little hard to tell. Yes, we did. Okay. Alright, so we should hold at around this altitude. The barometric pressure, we were kind of off, so we're a little on the high side. In terms of those mountains in front of us, I feel like we're okay because I'm looking at least the local ones were okay. The further ones, I don't know if we need to go over those or not. We'll deal with that when we get there. But I'm looking at the horizon line, or the clear line, I guess, for the airplane. These mountains seem to be fine. So I think we're stable for now. Let's go outside and look around a little bit. Game hesitated there for a moment when I turned my Xbox controller on. Alright, well already it's looking a lot interesting than the last two flights across Arizona and into New Mexico. Just miles and miles of very boring space, undeveloped, all of the same. So here we've got some real civilization going on. I don't know exactly where we are. Must be some interstate highway down there, perhaps. Kind of like those shots with the sun in the background. Sometimes, especially if it's reflecting off the plane. Get it to reflect off of a key portion of the plane. Oh well.
Priority Air 8, contact El Paso approach on 124.25.
I would like to go take a look at those mountains as we go by. So let's get the drone out.
124.25 for Priority Air 8.
And let's set the speed up. Alright, so I'm not sure where we are in relative to the plane. Maybe it's below us. Oh, yeah, it's right there. The drone moves much faster than the plane does. Now that's interesting. I think the plane won't have any trouble crossing. We could just sort of sit here and wait for it to go by. Of course, I'd have to turn off follow mode. That might be interesting. I'm going to try that for a minute. Alright, so follow mode's off. We'll stop. The plane will keep going. I can see it right there. So let's just watch that thing go across. That's interesting. Yeah, this drone feature is really cool, especially if you like the visuals and snapshots of cool scenes and whatnot. This is just a lot of fun. Alright, let me reset. External view, reset that. Go back inside where it's quiet. And that view's already reset. Actually, we can sit back. Head up a little bit. Looks like the sun's getting ready to go down. Still can't tell where the airport is in relation to those far mountain ranges, but I think it must be before them. I wouldn't want to miss seeing the sunset. I don't think we're quite there yet. I wonder if I could see it out the windows. Yeah, kinda. And it's not really gonna work. I'll go outside. And it's bouncing a little bit, probably from the wind effects of the mountains. Alright, so we got some time. Straight and narrow path. Could make sense to go ahead and reset the heading
point.
I suppose if it couldn't navigate for some reason, it would keep us going in that direction if I turned on heading.
Albuquerque Center, KH303, 8,000 feet.
KH303, Albuquerque Center, continue as planned. Altimeter tree, 0.01.
I was kind of like this shot. Kind of wonder what that dark spot is there. Tiny little bit of agriculture in the middle of nothing. So, the satellite data mismatch or something, who knows. Maybe they were missing data and they filled it in from older satellite data and it was is out of date. And then we've got some kind of a settlement over there. I do like the shadow effects with this graphics card, the RTX 2080 Ti. You can see the shadow on the propeller blades. She's, well, I guess, sunbeam showing on the dashboard. Just always looks really nice. Alright, so I'm going to go back outside again. Back to not having a whole lot to look at here. Except that funny spot. Feels very quiet out here. And the ground is getting green in front of us. Maybe that's shadows? Oh yeah, it's a shadow building from the sunset. Right. Well, these could make some interesting shots. Sun shining through these mountain gaps. So here's this water body.
120.6 KH303.
Found out in a previous video. Oh, look at that. Seams between satellites. Anyway, the drone is happy to land on the water, and you can actually hear the water waves if the water's moving. Hear a little bit now. It's happy to land here and boat around. Won't go below, so totally safe to do that. I'd like to see if I could get the sun reflecting in the water. Now what I discovered in the last video is I can go take a quick peek at the instruments. Speed's a little on the slow side, that's fine. Let me speed that up. So if I get the angle just right, I should be able to get a reflection on the water of the sun, but I don't know if that's going to work. It's a mountain. I think it's going to shadow it. Maybe this one will work. Almost. I think it'd have to be a little earlier for that to actually work. Alright, well, I'll head back to the plane. Alright, so we're up to a good speed now. We're going a little on the slow side, but not dangerously so, just going way too slow. I guess at some point I'll stop being fascinated by the sunsets, but I just find them really interesting. I guess that's one of my favorite natural features. Again, you can see the shadow on the propeller blade there. That's right, I can go all the way out to wide angle. Something out of an action movie. Well, that was fun. So again, I can't really tell about the mountain range and if we're going to clear it or not. Let's see what the Garmin says. Maybe I'll just go up to 10,000 or 11,000 and we'll be okay. So I'm looking at that clearance line and it looks like it's pretty low compared to the ranges. So let's go up just a bit. And by just a bit, I mean quite a bit. Let's go to 11,000. Do this is to first of all, let's see, what is the way to do this? I'm going way too fast, I was never going to be able to climb at that speed, so what I should do is slow down to a speed it can actually climb at, maybe in the 130s. Right. Turn on flight level change, and now it's got some headroom to speed up and start trying to head up there. Some throttle now to do so. Alright, we're good. So that'll get us up to 11,000. Sun's looking very yellow, so let's go outside and take a look at that yet again. Trying to get those cinematic reflections. Oops, got to not hit buttons and the controller. Okay, there we go. See if I can get some nice reflection on multiple windows or something. Oh yeah. That's, I guess, what I'm kind of looking for there. Okay, you really have to be careful with this controller when you're not in drone mode, because I accidentally hit a bumper and the flaps went down at high speed. That's dangerous. Alright, I'm going to go back inside, look at the Garmin, look at that clearance line, whatever it's called. I assume that's what it is. So, 11,000 might be enough. Go too high because then I have to lose all that altitude in order to land on the other side. But I can't resist another peek outside at the reddish glow. Well, kind of, it's still there. The sun is still there. Alright, well anyway. I do need to make sure I can get up over this mountain, it looks like. I'm just still not sure if 11,000 is enough. So let's set a target of 13,000. Give it a tiny little bit more throttle, but that might help a little bit. I don't want to overheat the engine. Well, if for some reason we're not going to clear it, we'll just turn and go around. Let's take a look at the Garmin again. So we're gaining on it. I think we'll be okay. This looks like we're clear now. We might not need the full 13,000. But I'll leave it that way for now. Getting a little bumpy, I guess, because of the wind. I mean, the hills. The sun is really trying to go down soon. I think our altitude's probably fine, so I'm going to take us out of flight level control or change into altitude hold. I can find it. There it is. Alright, so we'll hold at 11,600 or so. Should start speeding up substantially. Pop my head up and look. It's getting dark, but I think we're going to be fine. Again, the Garmin seems to suggest that. I do see a gap between the mountain range and our plane of plane, whatever that would be called. You do have to be a little careful using the mouse wheel because you can accidentally turn dials also when you're changing views. FYI. Reddish glow on the distance looks very realistic. Looks like a little sliver of the moon, is that? No. Oh, maybe it is, yeah. sliver of the moon. Right there. See a craft up here. I wonder if that shows up inside on our map. Not yet. Hit the right thing here, you can change the zoom. Okay, yeah, there it is. Sort of heading right towards us, sort of. But I think they're high enough above. Still, it looks like we're headed for a collision, so I'd like to go outside. Just reassure myself that they aren't at a nice altitude. I don't even see them. Oh, there they are. They're way up there, so we're fine. That's fine. Can't tell if it's a player or a simulated real flight or whatever. But yeah, no chance of collision there. We have a while to go before getting to Roswell. It's always a good time to take the drone out and play with it.
Albuquerque Center, KH303, 11,600 feet.
And let's see what we can see.
Albuquerque Center, continue as planned. Altimeter tree, 0.03.
Must be a park. I think I hear the plane above us somewhere. We are going faster than it when we move. Another strange case where it's putting like agricultural patches in weird places as if it's filling in the blanks with what it thinks ought to be there, like data's missing. Because I wouldn't think they would do crazy irregular patterns like that in a depression between, you know, a couple of hills, but who knows, maybe so. Hoping the USA update will take care of a lot of stuff like that, but I don't think it's gonna update everything everywhere. They might figure nobody's gonna be flying out here, so it doesn't matter to put a lot of effort in, but I do see the street, all the street lights down here, so that's good. So we can go check on the plane. Altitude is 11.6. Speed is good. Got some time. Should be fine, plenty of fuel, let's go back. Interesting how the lights are different colors, I wonder why that is. I wouldn't have thought that would be designed to be that way. Interesting. Maybe some kind of false colors or something. Alright, so other than those street lights, there's really not a lot going on here. Just a big open space. Sun is on its way down, we've got the moon. That's really beautiful. I flew one night when the full moon was out and it lit up everything. It was almost like flying at daytime. It was really, really nice. looks like it might be another plane right there. Or maybe that's us. Yeah, I think that's us. Let's go intercept. Looks like it's not moving. I think that's because we're moving towards it. I think if I stop, it will begin to appear to move. It's my theory. Let's see. Yep, there we go. Alright, so we can play all kinds of fun games with this. Stay ahead of it, let it crash into us. Get some interesting shots of it flying by. With the Doppler effect and everything. That is really cool. I gotta do that again. That is so cool. This is gonna become my new hobby. Trying to get the moon in a nice position. Oh, there he's down, way down there. Okay, so something that would just be really dramatic and kind of at the same level. That is so cool. Okay, enough fun and games for now. Go back inside where it's quiet. That first, and that, and then we're back inside. Okay. Oh, quieter. Not really quiet. I can see almost the whole rainbow of colors there in the atmosphere. So we are 44 nautical miles. So probably 20 minutes away from landing, something like that. You can see that overhead light now that I've got on. I made the mistake of starting out flying during the day and then it gets to be nighttime and you can't see anything. And it's a real pain. And at the time I didn't know that the dials for the all that was right down here. Could take this time to look at some of the instruments that aren't normally used. All the stuff for comm, never really need to use that. I don't know if there's a way to change this display to look like the map or not. Might be stuck in that view. I pressed that one time when other things were going wrong and it made a nasty noise. Always nice to get rid of the yoke. Oh, come on. Stop taking my click. Alright, door lock. I'm sure that's obviously not operable. I never use any of the stuff down here directly. That would be your trim. The flaps. Some of these things I don't really know how to use them when I need to use them or not. Aileron trim. Oh, I forgot about aileron trim. I saw those in the control mapping didn't think I would really ever need to use those. Okay, what is this? This says cool. AC to ventilate. ADF receiver. Cabin heat. At one point I wasn't able to take off because I was supposed to turn on cabin heat, so that was interesting. I'm not sure under what conditions. I guess it was, you know, super cold outside. Wouldn't want to touch any of these buttons in flight. That turns off the whole airplane. These are fuses. Parking brake. Okay, I'm surprised the button's so tiny. You can go into a lot of these menus. I don't normally need to use it very much, but you can turn on maps.
Hey. 303 contact Roswell approach on ONE 20.35.
120.35 KH303.
I'm hitting the screen, but it's not
Roswell touching. Approach KH303 11,600 feet.
KH303 Roswell approach. Continue as planned.
You could, if you'd use VOR instead of GPS guidance, you could switch that in here. I think when you switch it, you have to apply it before it takes effect, otherwise it might have started moving the plane around. You can move the map back and forth. I haven't been successful at creating a full flight plan yet, but I'm sure there's a way to do that. I've tried a couple times, I just didn't know what I was doing. That's about it. There's not much else going on here. There's, you know, things I never use having to do with changing fuel tanks and stuff. I don't know when it's appropriate to do anything with that. Oxygen. Can I turn oxygen on? I don't know. Can I change the... Yeah, I can certainly change the fuel tanks. I wouldn't want to do that, though. It is really getting dark out. Not too much longer before we land in Roswell. I don't know what to do in Roswell. Maybe look for aliens or something. I'm not sure. Maybe I'll do a tour of the area. I've never been there in person. Seems like we actually got off course when I switched the navigation method. So we're probably on heading, or no, I guess we're just on pitch control. So let's see if I can put this back on now. There we go. Alright, that'll fix it. I've been doing a much better job of keeping the engine cool. Often with full throttling it, then the torque and internal temperature would go too high, start blinking at me. I do have engine stress and airplane stress turned on, so that would make a difference, although it never seemed to cause a problem when it was alerting briefly, but you never know. At some point when I feel comfortable enough flying, I would like to introduce problems like having the engine shut off all of a sudden and just kind of see what would it be like to have to figure out what to do in that situation on your own. Hitting B, yep, where my barometer changed. So as a matter of fact, we're getting close enough now, I really do need to drop in altitude. So the way to do that would be to go back over here and I don't know, I guess the airport was at 3,000 something maybe. Let's start by going to 4,500. Turn on flight level change. Alright, and it's not going to do anything because it's already at full throttle, so if we de-throttle, it will drop to make up that loss in speed, and we'll start descent. Just going to check out the terrain. I think we're still quite fine, though, here. I think we're fine. Yep. So, not worried about that. Very difficult to see anything. Alright, so my altitude target was 4,500 feet, but I think I'm actually going to want that to be more like 5,500 feet because I'm thinking airport's at 3,600 and the landing pattern is probably 2,000 feet up from there, so I'm going to want to be there. 5,600, that sounds fine. Alright, it's enough to adjust that, it's already in flight level change, trying to get to that altitude, whatever we set there, so we're good. Go back outside. Stars look nice. Not much to see down. Oh, that's a pretty shot. Looks like a Halloween scene or something. Plane needs to be painted orange and black. Or have a jack-o'-lantern on it or something. Alright, so the pilot is going to contact the tower any moment. Set us up to come in for a landing. As soon as we hit altitude, I'm going to need to slow down quickly. We're going way too fast. I should have descended earlier and I didn't think about it. Worst comes to worst, we can just bypass the airport, come around and try again for a landing.
Roswell Tower KH303 is 11 miles southwest with Oscar to land. Traffic runway 21 KH303.
Alright, there's the landing pattern. We're at a good altitude now. I'm going to disengage autopilot because we don't need that right now. And the next thing would be to put the flaps down, lower the throttle, push on the stick, keep from nosing up. Speed down even more, and we'll head over towards that entrance. Looks like it's going to want us to be under 85. Glad I dimmed the avionics ahead of time, because that would have been really too bright right now in our face. Right, I've got the throttle at the center detent on the throttle stick. Seems to be a good spot for it right now. Feels calm. I'm not feeling like I have to use two hands on the stick at the moment. And I do have live weather set, but it, you know, it makes sense it would be calm out here, I guess. Okay, give it a little bit more thrust. I feel like we're a little low in speed. I'd like to have a little bit of margin just in case. Alright, now I feel like two hands on the stick. Nice. So I'm thinking about moving up to a faster plane. I've been looking at different planes. I found one that goes 250 knots, twin engine, a little small twin engine. I think it was a Beechcraft. Anyway, so I'm going to be looking for another plane soon. The Grand Caravan has served me well, but I feel like I need to grow a little bit and be nice to go faster. I can go longer distances if I had a faster plane without the videos becoming, you know, enormous. I think we're a little on the high side. I'm gonna drop a little bit. We'll pick up some speed, but that should be okay. Stars look really pretty from what I can see of them. So I think the blue brackets will turn red here when I get above 85. Oh, I guess 82.5, okay. I'm going to slow down a little bit on the thrust. Turn that speed off coming in. Feels nice and smooth so far. I think I see the runway down there. So it looks like we'll be doing a U-turn. Alright, I'm going to pick up speed just a little bit. We can afford to go faster right now, and also just to have some headroom. But it looks like we're on a really good approach here. We are at 5,100 feet. Be completely lost without the landing pattern system. I'd have to be super familiar with the airports to be able to figure out how to land just in, you know, in the dark without those. At some point, I'd hope to be that experienced in the game, but it's difficult to imagine right now. Alright, so again, this is really stable. Just one hand seems to be needed at this moment. I don't seem to need to pile both on. We'll do that though when I get to that turn coming up. Both turns, actually. Okay, I'm going a little slow. I'm going to thrust up a bit. Okay, we're getting some wind now. Plane's getting jostled a bit. So two hands on the stick, that should help. So I'd like to be going a little slower, but I think when I make those turns, it'll burn off some speed. So that'll help with that. A little on the high side, so it's going to make us go a little bit too fast. rest a bit, I guess that would help. Not sure how we actually got going that much faster, but I think I maybe wasn't perfectly catching the descent angle, and so we weren't gaining lower altitude in the process. Alright, so now we've burned off that excess, we've got to get some thrust to stay airborne. Thanks to the co-pilot for handling the tower traffic. Keeping an eye on that thrust, I don't want to go too low down towards 50. Do need to make a very sharp turn here. I'm going to give it a little extra thrust for that. Alright, now we're descending a lot, so I think we'll get speed out of that. Throttle a bit. Stars in the deep red sky looks beautiful. I haven't tried the game yet in HDR. I should give that a shot. I think it supports it. Alright, so now we need to slow down a bit more. I can see the red brackets. We're going to drop throttle way down, coast for a bit until we have to throttle up again. It's going to be another sharp turn, so it's going to burn off a bunch of that forward momentum. Hopefully, yep. And it's a very sharp turn here, but I think it'll be okay.
500.
Speed looks good. Burning off excess on these turns. We're getting a little low, so let's thrust up a bit. Head towards the runway more straight. Alright, so dropping throttle a bit, trying to keep an eye on that. It's a little hard to tell how close I am to the ground from here, but I think we're getting pretty close to gliding over the runway here. So let's go ahead and just float as long as we can. Drop throttle all the way. Just try to float. Bouncy. Okay, brakes. Flaps up.
KH-303, exit runway when able.
Alright. So we made it. A little faster landing than I'd like. I just really could not tell how close I was to the ground. I was nervous about that. But I think it was okay. I don't think the plane would have gotten any damage. Certainly didn't get any warnings about there being any damage or anything.
KH-303, turn next taxiway.
We will do that. Am I sticking on something? Maybe. Okay.
KH-303, contact ground on 121.9er.
Alright, let me...
121.9er for KH-303.
I'm gonna just park up here before the turn and I'll contact ground. Put the parking brake on.
Roswell ground, KH-303, request taxi to parking.
Oh, usually I have to do that. That was nice of the co-pilot to do that. Okay. Alright, here we go.
Taxiing to General Aviation Parking via taxiway Alpha Charlie KH-303.
Ooh, okay.
KH-303, hold position call. caution, other traffic.
Alright, we're holding. A little late on the notification.
KH303, continue taxi.
Thank you.
Roger, KH303.
That's a cool shot, Roswell International Air Center with the tower and the moon and everything. That is really cool. Don't see any aliens yet or any flying saucers or whatever. I'm sure I could find some add-ons though to, if I wanted those things. That would be kind of fun sometime. I kind of feel like staying away from the really ridiculous add-ons because I'm trying to achieve realism and learn, you know, digital flying. For instance, I'm not really. Oh, why are we going so fast? I'm not really interested in. I'm trying to break, and we are not breaking.
Roger, KH303.
The Godzilla add-on just seems a little bit too ridiculous for me. Oh, that's right, I got the parking brake on. Okay, here we go. That was a little scary feeling like I couldn't stop the plane. I think the problem was that I had thrust up still, and so I wasn't achieving net braking. Ah, there we go. Okay. Do we have clearance? Not hard to tell. Do I have a dude? I do. Oh, I can see his flashlights now. Okay. To the left, right. Are we good? No, I need to come a little bit more. Perfect. Okay, let's put the parking brake on. Shut the engine down. He disappears because he's not needed anymore. We're in Roswell though, so why not get the drone out and just kind of poke around a little bit? I doubt we're going to see anything, and it's nighttime. But it would be interesting to see if, you know, if there is any interesting thing to check out about this place. I think I'm going to want high-speed drone. Alright. So, I mean, it doesn't particularly look that interesting, just, you know, a place. Oh, that's cool. Yep, well anyway, don't really see much here, but let's go back in the plane. So, the engine should be off. Let me make sure I see the propeller and it's not spinning. I can't really see it. Oh yeah, there it is, alright. And let's turn off the plane. And that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.